Hello, Pythoneer. Want to make your Python apps easier to debug and maintain? Then stick around as we walk through Python Logging Explained, a quick guide to better debugging. In this video, you'll learn how to keep track of issues in your code, save error messages to a file, and even customize logs for better insights. What if I told you a few lines of code could make debugging 10 times easier? By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to do it. Let's start with the basics, and later on we check out a real code example. Alright, so first we need to import Python's built-in logging module, because we will use this here in this video. Next, we create a logger instance by calling logging.getLogger. This gives us a custom logger named after the current module, which means we can create specific logging behaviors for each file in our project, called name for example. Now, let's add some handlers. A handler controls where our log messages go. Here, I'm creating two handlers. Console handler, using the stream handler class that sends messages to the console. We could use the normal file handler class here like shown, but I would suggest you to better use the rotating file handler. This needs to be imported separately. The rotating file handler, using the rotating file handler class, sends the messages to a file named, e.g., app.log. It can be limited in file size, e.g., 2000 bytes, meaning it'll create a new file once it reaches that size. This way, our logs stay organized and we avoid creating massive log files. Let's take a short break. We didn't talk about yet why it's worth adding a logger to your profile. Using a logging module like this is crucial for any serious Python project. Logs help you monitor what's happening in your code while it's running and catch problems that may not cause immediate errors, but could lead to bigger issues later. For example, logging is great for tracking user actions in web apps, recording system errors in production environments, or troubleshooting background tasks in data processing scripts. With handlers set up, we need to set the log levels. Log levels determine which messages are sent to each handler. Here, I'm setting console handler to warning, so warning and error messages show up in the console. For rotating file handler, I'm setting it to error, meaning only error messages will be saved to the log file. Next, we can customize our log messages with a formatter. A clear format makes it easy to understand what happened and when. You can run the help function on the logging.formatter class to see available variables you can access. Here, you can also see all you can do on the formatting. Check it out. Mine here is the basic example to you. This format string here tells Python to include the timestamp, logger name, log level, and the actual message. As I finish up the format string, let me know if you're enjoying the video. If so, please like, subscribe, and drop any feedback in the comments. Next step is to apply this logging format to the two handlers console and rotating file using the setFormatter function. To complete the setup, we attach our handlers to the logger using the addHandler function. Adding these handlers ensures that the logger knows where to send messages based on the levels we configured. Now we're ready to log messages. Here's an example. I'll log a warning message and an error message that I use the warning and error function to manual rise it. When I run this code, the warning appears in the console, while the error appears in the console and is additionally saved to app.log file. This approach is great for tracking issues as they happen and storing critical errors for later analysis. And that's it for the basics. Now it's time to talk about how you could use this embedded in your code without creating manual errors, like I did here. Therefore, I prepared some code for you I want to walk you through. In the example, we raise and handle errors when we try to open a file that doesn't exist. The first big change you can see here is that you can configure the logging a way more compact using the basic config function. Here we can set the level, the format, and the handlers to store an error in a file and see it in the console. Then I created a function called readFile, which takes a file as input. Inside here, I use the try-except syntax to catch and handle errors, try to open the file, read it, and return data. Then I set up two exceptions to catch first a file not found error, and second, a general exception to catch any other error. Both of them are written to the file error log and the console because we set up the rotating file handler and the stream handler above. As we can see now in example, when we run the function with a file that doesn't exist, we raise the file not found error and show it in both directions. And that's it. Let's do a short recap before we end this. Python's logging module keeps your debugging process organized, saves critical error messages, and gives you full control over how and where logs are saved. If you found this helpful, please like, make sure you're subscribed, and check out the video YouTube suggests for you on the left for more Python tips. Thanks for watching, and happy coding!